Good afternoon, my tigers and tigresses. So here we will discuss the simple present tense or the present indefinite tense. See, it is written there that simple present tense is used. There are three categories and three conditions where these tenses are used. One is to express general truth. The earth moves around the sun. Or you can also say that Suman sir kills a tiger, like that. To describe a habit or custom, I go to school every day. Means this is your habit, that is habitual truth. Another such condition is to express what is actually taking place at the present moment. Right now, Suman sir teaches English, or you play football. These are the thing. I write, he comes. Right, like that, here comes the train, which means the train is coming. The thing is happening in present. I write means I am writing. Suman sir teaches means I am teaching right now. So that is how these are the three conditions where the present tenses are used. So now let's move over to the next page where it is written that the uses of simple present tense. Which are the scenarios where we should use simple present tense and do not use any other thing? That is, to describe past events in order to make the description seem more vivid. Where is it? That kind of thing is called historic present. Means already the thing has happened in past, but you are describing it in a way to make it alive, to make it more prominent for the readers, for the listeners. And that's how, in order to describe those past events, especially historical events, we often write those events in present tense. That is why we call it historic present. Means you are writing it in present tense, but actually the thing, the action had happened in past. These are the things which are generally used in literature. If you are composing anything like story or essay, or you want to make your essay or story more vivid, more catchy, in that case you can use such type of examples. See, it is written there here that once you read it, you can see the picture in your mind's eye. Him whose army now advances and the bloody battle commences between Akbar and Himu, the battle of Panipat, which is in Haryana right now, and it was probably the second battle of Panipat. Now comes another thing, which is the fifth one, that is to summarize a story or describe an action in a dramatic manner. Mohammad Shami runs up to the wicket, he bowls. I hope most of you listen to commentary, especially sports commentary. Often these commentaries are meant in present tense. Not only often, I should say, always, most of the time, these commentaries are made in present tense, because the commentator wants the spectators and the listeners to feel what is happening right now in the field. Especially those who are not present in the field, for them it is very helpful. I can remember when I was young, I used to listen to the radios and I used to listen to the commentary of the Indian cricket matches. And those commentaries were really very helpful for me to understand how to describe an event, how to describe an event like a match, and how to describe it more vividly so that the listeners can feel and see in their imagination what is going on inside the ground. Now, the next one is a sixth one, that is to quote authors, whether living or dead. Suppose Shakespeare, suppose Rousseau, suppose Bernard Shaw, suppose Percy Bysshe Shelley, suppose Keats, suppose Jivanananda, Rabindranath Tagore. If you quote their sayings, it is better you use an inverted comma and you write it in present tense. That will make it relevant even now. And we know, because we are reading their books till now, which means they had done something that is still relevant today. Even in our time, it is relevant, and that is most effective also. Like here it is written, that the match starts at 5 o'clock. The train leaves at 6:30. Means these are the events. No, sorry. The Shakespeare says life is but a walking shadow. Means this is something which was said by Shakespeare. The next point, point number 7, is to express a future event that is a part of a fixed timetable. And fixed timetable means this is the arrival and departure of trains, planes, opening of schools, your arrival at school or your departure from school. These are the things which are fixed. And because these things are fixed, we can use, we can describe these events in present tense. Like the match starts at 5 o'clock, the train leaves at 6:30. That is how these things are used in order to use the simple present tense, that is, you can call it the present indefinite tense. Remember one thing, in this tense, the verb is used in main form. If the subject is third person singular number, then the verb will take s or es with it, and then the sentence will be constructed. Like, I play football, but he plays football. That's how, depending on the number and person of the subject, the verb will also add s or es with it. That's how the present tense is done. So we will move over to the next part. Problem.